not a long time ago, an old lady came to my clinic, sat in front of me as in pain, as she said, "Dr. Xia, I've been coughing these days. My chest doesn't hurt, but my waist and my back are killing me." So I tapped on her most painful spot. The old lady cried in pain. So I immediately stopped my check and told her that she probably get a fracture. She looked at me in great surprise. "How? How is it possible? Such strong bone just broken just because of cough." Most of you might have the same question. How is it possible? Such strong bone of us could break because of a cough. So I carried on with some examinations. And here we can see a very clear acute compression fracture on her second lumbar vertebral body. So why she had a fracture? It is because her bone is so weak that they can't even stand a cough. Her bone developed problems long times ago, but she never received any treatment. So let's talk about bones. The human skeleton is made up of 206 bones. It is the fundamental structure of the human body. Let's put it this way. Almost all our vital organs and the tissues are attached to the bones. When we are young, we have smaller and lighter bones. As we grow older, our bones grow larger under the influence of different kinds of hormones and ultimately reach a peak stage, which we call the peak bone mass. An average person reaches their peak bone mass between the age 20 to 30 years old. The peak bone mass is very important that determines our bone health in the future. I often use an analogy to explain peak bone mass to my patients. Think of it as your savings. When you are young, the more you're saving, the more affluent you are when you grow older. Individual genes determines 70% of peak bone mass. Then another 30% is closely related to regular life, diet, disease, medication. So since we can't alter our genes, if you want bone, you need to maintain regular exercise, less illness, less medication, and eat more food that promote bone stress like milk. As I told before, we reach the peak bone mass around the age of 30. Then what happens after 30? Is our bone mass declining? Actually, no. This is another important concept. Bone reconstruction comes in. Bone reconstruction consists of two parts, bone absorption and bone formation. It seems to be little change to our skeletons, but bone absorption and bone formation take place every second. Bone reconstruction is a continuous process. Older bones are absorbed, new bones are formed. However, bone reconstruction is not always constant. Sometimes bone formation exceeds bone absorption. The bones grow. The typical time period is during the puberty, like the age 10 years old to 18 years old. We grow taller. And after this kind of, after we reach the 30, we have reached the average stage of peak bone mass. And at this stage, the bone absorption and the bone formation reaches an equilibrium, and the bone mass maintains an equilibrium too. And And after what? However, as our age increase, the bone absorption gradually exceeds bone formation, we are going to face bone loss. It's most common among the females, especially after the year of 50 years old, when they go through the menopause. Decrease in bone mass and the decrease in the bone quality that becomes so dominant that a slight impact can cause fracture. This is acceptance of osteoporosis. We often heard about those three diseases: shock, attack, breast cancer. But osteoporosis is less familiar for us, but it's more common than these three diseases. So in fact, the incidence of the osteoporosis alone is higher than the sum of those three diseases. Every 3 seconds, there was a new case of osteoporotic fracture in the world. If we don't take actions, by the year of 2015, there will be 6 million new cases in China. It's a huge number. Meanwhile, osteoporotic fracture is the main cause of disability and death for the older people. Let's take hip fracture as an example. If an older man experiences a hip fracture, the mortality will be 20% within 1 year. 30% of the older people will suffer a permanent disability, which will cause huge expense of resources and fundings. And by the year 2015, the government of China needed to spend 163 billion yuan to treat osteoporotic fracture alone. This is a huge number, like 10% of the total expense of the national health insurance for all disease. It's a huge number. The serious part is this. Once you experience an osteoporotic fracture, recurrence is above average population, especially for the patient who missed the early diagnosis and the test. And for half of those patients, they will face another osteoporotic fracture within 1 to 2 years. To tackle this problem, the International Osteoporosis Foundation has proposed a program called Capture the Fracture. They aim to provide a standard service, fracture liaison service, or FLS, for the patient. Our hospital is one of the first hospitals to start FLS in China. Once an osteoporotic fracture occurs in our hospital, we will provide a standard FLS for the patient. Here is a figure. As we can see, the rate of osteoporosis diagnosis and treatment before we start FLS and 2 years later. As we can see, the rate for the diagnosis is increased from less than 15% to 80%. The rate of treatment is increased from less than 30% to 90%. As we discussed about the osteoporosis fracture, but how much do we know about this disease? And I'm wondering, how many of us know this disease about before we talking about this disease? In China, the rate of osteoporosis above the age 15 is 19.2%. For the female, it's 32.1%. This means 3 in 10 females are osteoporotic patients. The rate increased to 32% for the population over 65. For the female, it's 51.6. This means 1 in 2 female are osteoporotic patients. Your mom and my mom could all be one of some. Sounds terrifying. But how much do we know about this disease? The National Health Commission carried out a survey among the adults. Only 11.7% of the people knew it, and only 3.7% of the people above 15 years old have a bone density test, which is the most important test for osteoporosis. This means the majority of the patients miss the test, or treated, or diagnosed. The consequence is fracture after another fracture. Sounds terrible. So it's unfair to blame everyone, because in the first time, in the beginning, there is no clinical symptoms for the early osteoporosis. Its unobservable nature gave its name, the silent disease. But as the osteoporosis derived father, if we still unable to identify it, then you need to face continuous pain all over your body and along with body deformity, humpbacks, and the recurrence of fractures. So what should we do? First of all, I would emphasize that the osteoporosis is preventable and curable. Some steps is early screening and identification. So I advise the following groups to book an examination. People who are over 60 years old, people who accept the osteoporotic risk factors like the menopause before 45, and has family history and long-term medication on glucocorticoid like prednisone, and decrease with the height after 40. The sooner, the better. So the key point is the early treatment for osteoporosis is easy and inexpensive, but very effective. But how do we treat osteoporosis? Let's go back to the concept bone reconstruction. As we know, when bone absorption exceeds bone formation, we are facing to lose our bone. So as long as we identify this trait in time and intervene with adjusting lifestyle or exercise or with assistance of medication, we are able to reduce the rate of bone absorption and increase the rate of bone formation. Then our bone grow again. I was on 24-hour duty yesterday, and old lady came to me. She was diagnosed with osteoporosis at the age of 65. After 1 year treatment, she was so happy with the result of her report. She told me, "Dr. Xia, I'm recovered. My bone grow again." Finally, I would like to use this picture to end my presentation. This picture summarizes different groups of osteoporosis. The first group has osteoporosis, has been through with osteoporotic fracture, but never received any treatment or take any medication. What then is faced is one fracture after another. It's just like jumping off a cliff without a parachute. Then, boom, it's not going to end well. The second group who has osteoporosis, who have been go through osteoporotic fracture, but they have received proper treatment. Even though they jump off a cliff, we have equipped them with a parachute to secure a soft landing. However, what matters most, I think, is understand our bones and try our best to present ourselves from jump. Thank you very much.